Hello dear friends, the next page is output A in this video, and we will talk about output A and sub pages of output A, dimming and fault. Firstly, I would like to mention that we have different objects: output object, group object, and ballast object. For example, when you send switch on telegram by using this ballast object, you can control just that ballast. You can control just ballast 1. But when you send switch on or off command telegram by using this object, you can control your lightings, which are in group 1. If you add 5 lighting in group 1, you can control those 5 lightings. But at this part, you can control your all lightings which are connected to your channel A, output A. You can control your all lightings which is in output A. When you send switch on telegram, your all lightings will be turned on. After this, we can talk about this page. Now, when you choose logarithmic or linear, it will affect your all lightings which is connected to your output A, channel A. Because of that, I would like to talk about this part. Anyway, we can give any name for my output. You can change this part, you can change this text, and selected dimming curve parameter, logarithmic and linear. We are using this parameter to define DALI dimming characteristic. To make it understandable, let me open a picture, graphic picture. For example, this is linear and this is logarithmic. 0% to 100%. When you choose logarithmic, your dimming curve will be like this. I mean, it's increasing slowly and too faster. When you choose linear, it's going stable. This is difference. Generally, we choose this one linear. Brightness value when switching on. It means that when you send telegram to switch on, your lighting will be turned on in this brightness value. Now 100. When you choose 90%, when you send switch on telegram, your lighting will be set in 90 brightness value. Dimming time. This is the time between current brightness value and desired brightness value. I mean, when you set 0, it is going to desired brightness value from current brightness value immediately. But when you make it 10, during this time it is going to desired brightness value from current brightness value. For example, your current brightness value is 20% and your desired value is 50%, it's going from 20 to 50 during this time. Generally, we make it 0. Switch off at turn off brightness. In case it is chosen as no, we send off telegram and the lighting is switching off completely. I mean, when we choose no and you send off telegram, your lighting is switching off completely, 0%, zero brightness. But when we choose yes and when you arrange a brightness value 25, when you, and in this case if you send off telegram, it will be in 25%. This is difference. Now we can check dimming page. In here, upper dimming value and lower dimming value. For instance, I set 10 for lower dimming value and 90 for upper dimming value. In this case, you can change your dimming value, your brightness level between these upper and lower values. You cannot set your lightings in 8 brightness value or higher brightness value than 90. You cannot, because your upper dimming value is 90. You can set your lightings maximum in 90%. Relative dimming reaction, brightness dimming reaction. We know that we have two different dimming object, relative dimming object and brightness dimming object. These parameters are same for both. If you need relative dimming object 4 bit, you can choose this one. If you need 1 byte object to control your brightness value, dimming value, you can choose this object. And parameters are same for both in this page. Dimming time for relative. During this time, your brightness level is increasing or decreasing between your current brightness value and desired brightness value, set brightness value. It is going down and up during this time. Allow on via relative dim, allow off via relative dim. These parameters are using for switch on off control by using relative dim object. As you know that we are using relative dim and brightness dim object to change brightness level. But when I set these parameters, we can use this object to switch on off. For example, when you choose yes and your lighting is off right now, we send 30 or 40% brightness value by using relative dim object. But your lighting is in off right now. In this case, your lighting will be switched on and its brightness will be 30%. But when you choose no, and when you send 30% brightness value by using relative dim object, your lighting will not be switched on. By using relative dim object, if you wanna switch on off operation, you must set this parameter. Here is the same as well. No need to talk about this part. Now fault page. If you wanna get fault info, fault data from KNX, from Dali Gateway, you must arrange this page. For example, fault messages and status. When you choose yes, it's opening you acknowledge fault messages status 1 bit. If you have any problem in your output A, any fault, you will get 1 data from this object. For example, you wanna get lamp fault, ballast fault, and others, you must choose yes, and it will open an object for that fault. Let me check it. Lamp fault, ballast fault, 1 bit, as you see that. When you have a fault regarding your lamp or ballast, you will get data from this object. That's it. That's all in this video. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for watching this video. See see you in the next videos.